Hello, folks. I'm awfully sad. Mr. Sixpence passed away yesterday. Poor Mr. Sixpence. I loved him so much. You know, I'm a night owl. I get up, wander around all night. The cat used to follow me everywhere. And I was up last night. I really missed him. Had him 19 years. You know,
it's hard.
Terrible loss for me. He was my best mate. Mr. Sixpence, rest in peace. Look, he's in a nice place. I brought him home from the vets. I'm going to miss him terribly. There will never be another cat to replace him. Anyway. See you, Mr. Sixpence. I'll see you soon, maybe.
Yeah. That's the whole. this away. There's just some downhill scratching. It's a bit hard. Ooh. Ooh. Come on, you can do it. You can do it, puss. Hello, puss. Good kiss.
So, we can't leave on a sad note. So, here's a good joke by Norm MacDonald. I love Norm MacDonald. And I'll see you on the next one.
But how you doing? Everything okay at your house? Everything good?
Oh, yeah. Well, I'm having a little trouble. I have a cat, you know?
You have a cat? I didn't know you're a big cat lover. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. No, I don't love them, but I have one.
Yeah. I don't understand that.
I keep it at a platonic level.
Oh, yeah. I see. Yeah.
I have a cat, my friend Steve Corin, you know, who's a great man.
Yeah.
He's a good guy. He was living in New York City when I was living there, and he was my buddy. And then he left. He went to L.A., you know, Los Angeles. How would you not know that? And he's working on the Seinfeld show now. So he goes, hey, Norm, I'll give you my cat free. You know, so I'm always looking for a good deal, you know.
Yeah, free.
A free cat. So I get this cat. So then, like, a couple weeks later, he has a heart attack.
The cat?
Yeah. Have you ever heard of such a thing?
No, but...
I know. Wow. Who would know a cat could even have a heart attack? It's crazy.
So what happened?
I came home, and I go, okay. And I walk through my door, you know, into my apartment, and there's the cat, and he's got, like, foam coming out of his mouth, and he's going, like... And there's foam and everything, and he's like crazy, you know, he's acting like a crazy cat.
Right.
And so, like, I'm scared. I don't want to go near him because I can tell, like, he's delirious and maybe, I don't know.
Sure, yeah.
You don't know.
Anything could happen.
Yeah, he could think I was a mouse or something, you know, and, like, bite me. So I go, I got to do something, man. My cat, something's wrong with him, you know. He's not supposed to be doing this. So quickly, I think quick, you know.
Yeah.
I grab the phone. I phone 911, you know.
911.
And, it turns out they don't want to hear about a cat.
No, that's
only for people, you know? They said that to me. They go, this is for people. So I said, all right. I don't know what to do. What's the cat number? They go, just get off the phone. You know? They got to keep the lines free. You know what I'm saying? They don't want to hear about that. So I don't know what to do. So my neighbor, you know, Bill.
Right. Yeah.
You know, it doesn't matter what his name is, but his name is Bill. So I knock on his door. Bill. He's not home. Some other guy's there. You know, I don't know what the hell is going on there. But the other guy comes. I don't ask questions, you know.
Get involved.
So I say, listen, I don't know who you are. I don't know what you're doing at Bill's place. But my cat is in deep trouble, you know. He's going, and he's got stuff coming out. So the guy goes, we got to get him to a hospital, you know. So I go, look, I just phoned 911. I'm sure they don't want to see a cat at a hospital either. He goes, no, there's animal hospitals, you know. So he took me to this, it's a place called an animal hospital. I swear to God, they actually have these. You can bring your cat there. Do you have a cat?
Yeah, I know an animal hospital. I have them all over the place. Quite common, but okay. Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. So I ring my cat and I go, Doc. There's a doc there, you know.
Right.
They have doctors.
For cats.
They have cat doctors. So I go, listen, Doc, my cat, something. So they take him away, you know, and I'm sitting like in they have a waiting room. It's exactly like a real place, except it's ridiculous, you know. So everyone's sitting around, they're worried, you know. Oh, I hope my dog is all right, you know. So the guy brings me in the office and he goes, you know, your cat is at a heart attack. So I go, come on, my cat did not have a heart attack. And he goes, no, seriously. And I go, well, how can a cat have a heart attack? He goes, oh, many different things. He goes, diet, stress, you know. Like, how the hell could a cat have stress, you know? That's not true. This guy's just making up stuff, you know?
You think he's making up stuff?
Well, no. My cat has a big promotion coming up. He's got worried, you know.
He's worried about it.
And, so I said to the guy, okay, I go, fair enough. I'll go along with it. He goes, now, he says, I'll let you visit with your cat. They have a visiting time. This is the oddest part of the whole thing. Yeah. They take you in a room, and then they bring your cat in, and he's all drugged up. They got him drugged, and they put him on like a gurney, and he's like standing there like this. And then the guy says, okay. He says, you only have 30 minutes to talk to your cat. So he leaves. You're in a room with a cat for like 30 minutes. It's like crazy. So then after like 5 minutes, you go, I got a life to get back to. You know? I can't talk to a cat.